In this video, I want to talk about SSL and TLS support in Virtualmin. SSL provides encrypted websites. It provides encryption for other services like mail and Webmin itself even. And Webmin, of course, defaults to running over SSL. As you may recall from an earlier video we did, we logged in via HTTPS, which indicates that it is encrypted. But when we logged in, we received a certificate validation error, and we had to click through and say, yeah, it's okay. I really want to log into this server, even though this is a self-signed certificate. So in this video, we're going to talk about how to get rid of that validation warning or that self-signed certificate warning. And we'll talk about how to get a free certificate from Let's Encrypt, which is a free and automated and open certificate authority. It was founded by Mozilla and EFF and some other organizations that all got together and said, you know what, if we're going to have the entire internet encrypted, we need an organization out there that is giving away certificates so that it's really simple and really easy and really cheap, basically free, for anyone to get an SSL certificate for their website. So it is donor-sponsored, so it still costs money to run it, but you and I don't have to pay for it, although they probably do support, they do allow donations, which is cool, so you can support that. Okay, so we're going to talk about it in Virtualmin today, and if you'll recall from the previous videos, I installed this on a virtual machine that we have at one of the virtual machine providers that are out there. I created a new virtual server or a domain in Virtualmin called tutorials.vmin.pw, and that's just a dummy site I've set up for our experiments in these videos. And at the time, when I created the domain, I enabled the SSL website feature. So if you're following along at home for one of your Virtualmin domains and you want to do this and you want to create your own SSL certificate using Let's Encrypt, you'll want to make sure you have enabled Apache SSL website. If you're using Nginx, there would be a feature for that as well. The actual SSL features are very similar in either web server. And so now that we know that's enabled, we want to go to server configuration over here in the domain menus. And I'm going to click on Manage SSL Certificate. And now when I created this domain, it received a self-signed certificate. This is one that was generated by Virtualmin and installed for this domain. But if we want a certificate that does not present a warning, we need to get a real certificate, one that is signed by a certificate authority. And so I'm going to go ahead and create a Let's Encrypt certificate using Virtualmin. And it's super simple. I just clicked on this tab over here for Let's Encrypt, and I'm going to request a certificate for the domains associated with this server. If I had any alias domains, they would also be listed over here. If I had mail service enabled, the mail.tutorials.vmin.pw address would be listed there, etc. And then we want to renew this. So Let's Encrypt certificates expire after 90 days. That's 3 months, roughly. And that is just the way they work. And so we default to renewing these automatically every 2 months, which gives it a little time if something goes wrong with validation or whatever when renewing. So you have a little time, so you won't end up with an expired certificate while you take a few days to figure out what went wrong if something went wrong. And things can go wrong, and we're going to talk about in a minute the things that can go wrong when validating Let's Encrypt and creating Let's Encrypt certificates. But so basically there's nothing to it. I mean, we just choose what domains to do, and if we wanted only some of these domains, we could specify them here. If we wanted some additional domains, although again, when we talk about what can go wrong, we'll talk about how adding domains here might cause things to go wrong. But I'm going to go ahead and request certificate. And what this does is it creates it uses the Let's Encrypt API. It communicates with them and says, hey, we want a certificate for this domain and this domain. And it sends it to Let's Encrypt. And Let's Encrypt says, okay, put this little file, this key that we're going to hand you on your web server in a place where we can find it. And this allows Let's Encrypt to verify that you're actually the owner of that domain. It would be dangerous for someone to be able to create an SSL certificate that claims to be your name if someone didn't actually own the domain. And that might be a little beyond the scope of this to talk about the risks involved in that, like man-in-the-middle attacks and that kind of thing. So I won't go into too much detail about why it's a big deal that they validate that your domain actually belongs to you. But I do want to talk about how that validation works. And what happens, like I say, is it creates a file in a well-known location and notifies Let's Encrypt. It says, hey, we created that file for you. You can check it. And Let's Encrypt makes a web request and asks your server, hey, do you have this file? Okay, does it contain the key that we gave you? This little long, is sort of a long series of characters that just validates that I'm actually the person that made the request earlier, and now you know that I own this domain. I think I described that a lot more complicated than it actually is. But then there's the other thing, I want to talk about, which is that Virtualmin can also validate via DNS. So if your website isn't working for some reason, or if you have redirects set up that prevent Let's Encrypt from getting through, it may be able to fall back to using DNS. And so Virtualmin will also be able to set up a special DNS text record for Let's Encrypt, and Let's Encrypt can make a request for that DNS text record. And it's the same information, it's that same key that we talk about that Let's Encrypt provided and said, okay, here's the key, put that somewhere where we can find it to prove that you own this domain. And so there's a couple of different ways for Let's Encrypt to validate, and Webmin and Virtualmin support both of those ways. But that also tells us the ways that this can fail. Both of these methods rely on DNS working. DNS doesn't necessarily have to be hosted by the Virtualmin server itself, but if any of these records are missing from the zone, wherever it's hosted, so if you've chosen to host your DNS somewhere outside of your Virtualmin server, say you host it on Amazon's Route 53, or you host it on your registrar, some of them provide free DNS hosting. If you host it with, there's a whole lot of them. Den DNS is a good one, and so on. There's a bunch of ways you can host DNS that takes it out of the control of Virtualmin. That can still work, but only the web validation method can work with that. And in that case, you have to make sure you don't have any redirects happening that prevent access to the .well-known directory path. And you have to make sure that DNS is valid for all of those domains. All of the records that you have here, all of these names that you chose on that request certificate form have to be there. So that's the thing. Those are the things that can go wrong. If you don't have DNS and you have some kind of redirect, or you have some kind of redirect that prevents access to that well-known directory, those are the reasons that it can fail. And we've, despite this being really simple and there only being, you know, like one or two options on the form, people still manage to get it wrong and still manage to have trouble with it. And we still get a lot of requests for Let's Encrypt support just because DNS is hard and sometimes getting the correct redirects and proxy rules and that kind of thing right. So if you've got a web application that has its own HT access file and it sets up some redirects or it sets up proxy rules, if it's not specific enough, if it doesn't exclude that well-known directory, you can still break your Let's Encrypt certificates after you get them, and Virtualmin won't be able to re-request, you know, renew that certificate later. And so it creates a file in, you know, home/tutorials/public.html. It's actually in a directory /.well-known. And again, if anything is preventing access to that, that will prevent renewals or prevent the initial request certificate from happening. And so now we should be able to browse to HTTPS because our certificate did validate. And there we go. And as you can see, we now have a, instead of this kind of lock, where it's giving us a warning, because that's a self-signed certificate, which provides no proof that we're actually talking to the domain we think we are. Whereas this one has a real verified certificate. All right, I think that's all I want to cover in this video. Again, Let's Encrypt support in Virtualmin is super simple to use, but there are a few things that can go wrong. Some of them are outside of the control of Virtualmin. But if you understand how Let's Encrypt works and how it validates your domain, it's usually pretty easy to troubleshoot what's going wrong. So thanks for watching. If there's anything you think I should have covered about this, let me know in the comments. If there's anything you want to see in the future, again, let me know in the comments. Like and subscribe if you like seeing videos about Virtualmin. If I know people are watching them and liking them, then I will keep making them. Thanks for watching.